This is Jonathan Omer with a screencast for Make Lemonade. Today I'm going to show you, Zach, how to add content to our top reads section from our Dropbox files. So I have a couple things going on here. I have two tabs open. One is the front end of the site, so I can see the web page. And then the second is the admin area, where we actually edit and add content to our site. I also, over here, have our page open, so I can add this to our site. So the thing that I want to do first is just go ahead and copy all this content. Now, since we're repeating this on our other pages, I'm actually just going to grab this section here, because this 9 best lenders is something that we're copying and pasting through each document. So I'm going to go ahead and just do a copy, and I'm going to slide back over, and I'm going to go to add a new post. So right now our post here is a long list, so we're just going to go ahead and add a new one. So if you're familiar with WordPress, this will look very similar to what you've done in the past. Now what we're doing, we have a new editor that we're using, so we're going to click on the backend editor if it's not already available to you. And we're going to use the Visual Composer plugin to basically create our page layouts. Now this page is mostly just one big text block, so I'm going to go ahead and do Add Text Block. And I'm going to then hover in here and tap the Edit button. And I'm going to go ahead and paste all of that content in. Now sometimes pasting the content in looks really good. One of the things that I've noticed from what you've sent me and everything is that sometimes I'm copying in that title, so we don't really need that in this portion. Another thing that I see is that our numbers get kind of messed up. Say there's a number 1, and then it's the number 1 again. And part of that is the way that Word and Pages brings in our numbered list. If these aren't actual forced numbered list and you're doing some different shift returns in that, sometimes this stuff ends up a little wonky. So this is where I'm going in and having to make some changes to the content as far as how the pages are laid out. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to click on that first line, and what I did is I hit delete, and then I did a shift return to put this content underneath of this. And I'm going to do the same here. Delete, shift return. Now this is a bulleted list, so I'm going to undo that there. I'm going to hit a hard return, but we want this to be a bullet underneath there. So what I did there, again, I hit return, so it's going to do number 2 because it's thinking it's the second in this list. Hit tab to indent, and now it's doing the indented list, but we want that to be the bullet. So lemonade tip is the bullet. Okay, you can see that. So now this one, again, it's going to want to follow that order, so I can hit delete, hit return. So again, it's looking like this second headline wants to be underneath the lemonade tip, but we're going to do shift tab to back out. And again, I'm tab to go in, and then I'm changing from a numbered list to a bullet list. That way we maintain the numbers out here, but the bullets within are lemonade tips. So again, delete, return, shift tab to come out for that line, and then shift shift return to go down to keep that next little paragraph within our numbered list. Return. Now, as I'm doing this, again, we're noticing that we have some links here. So sometimes what you might want to do is, if you have a hyperlink, you want to hyperlink some text. I'm not really sure here what text you want to link, but let me just look up here for a little bit. So let's see, our first link here we have, so let's do this. I don't even know if I have that article. So let's highlight that text and come up here to the hyperlink. Let's just start typing, should I choose? And it looks like we do have that link there. So again, I just so let's so again, find the link text that you want. Okay, here we go. Link to student loan calculator, paying off student loans. Now this one might change, but we can go ahead and highlight that text. Come up here to the hyperlink, and then if you just start typing in student loan calculator, and we want the paying off, which one is that? Paying off student loans versus investing. I'm not seeing that one, so I might not have that one written yet, that page written. Here we go, we can do this. The nine best article. Again, I'm just going to delete, clean up that content a little bit, and then highlight that, hit let link, and then we can do best student loan. This one because this is the actual post and not the page since we switched things out for the sidebar. So I'm going to hit apply. So at this point right now, this is where I usually just go ahead and hit save. You'll see that content is all poured in there. Oh, looks like I missed one at the bottom here. Let's scroll down a little bit. So let's clean that up. Eliminate it needs to come in and go like that, and we clean that up. Save. Now everything's in line. Now we do need a page title or a post title, so let's come back here. Here's our post title. And this one is underneath our top reads. So we're gonna check this category. So I gave it a post title, and I've checked this category. If we have a featured image, which the other posts do, you can go ahead and select a featured image. So I know we used most of these. And I'm not really sure. I don't think I used this one. So I'm going to just go ahead and use this one just for this example. Hit set. I set the featured image. I can publish that then. And then once that's done, and this all refreshes. Okay, I'm back. I had to take a little pause. I actually had an issue. I had created this post, and so I was getting an error where it was saying that that post was already created. I didn't realize that the five things to consider was a part of our sidebar items that I had already done. So if we look here, so the five things to consider is right there. So I have that post here. Sorry, right here. And so you can see we actually have this coffee po picture. So there, the page title is there, the coffee is there as well, and then we have all this content here. So this one was done before, so I hadn't gone through and linked everything in your text. But in this video, like I said, I showed you how to link those, so you should be able to do that. So if you can get started on these, again, it's just add new post, put in the title, switch to the backend editor, and then put in a text block. If it does have unique content, like a table or anything like that, just make a note of that one and send it over to me. Also, if it has the 9 best loans, if you want that table and everything underneath there, let me know. That way I can put those in there later. But for now, just go ahead and add those. I'll also update your password and resend you that. So let me know if you have any issues there. Thanks. Bye.